Hi, and thank you for joining me today. I am Jackie Horton, your virtual wellness and health specialist. I'm here to promote wellness and good health. Jackie Horton, your wellness and health specialist on a freezing cold Thursday for life coaching series. Just wanted to remind you for year 2024, it is probably the best year to start working on your finance and creating some real goals regarding what your finance can become as you employ actual steps to get that outcome that you desire. So, one thing I would suggest you do every month, save the same amount of money for the same number of days in a month. That's one thing. So if it's 30 days in a month, put $30 aside. If it's 31 days, do it starting January into the end of this year. And get used to putting that money aside and keeping it accessible. Don't lock it off in a bank or anything like that, because one of the best disciplines is to have access to something but choose not to partake in it or use it. So each month, save the amount of the number of days in the month starting January. That's one thing. The second thing I would encourage you to do, just to practice, you know, learning how to discipline yourself regarding finance, is to think about what you would like to purchase this year, but you would be willing to purchase it straight out. Now, if you do not have money for a full amount of a car, then obviously I wouldn't suggest you focus on that. But I want you to get used to using your money for big items, such as spending $500 where you see it come out of your hand and transfer into the hands of someone else for merchandise. And the reason that you want to do that, I was reading one of Susie Orsman's book and a long time ago, and she was really encouraging everybody to get out of the plastic, meaning using our cars, and start to see the use of cash again, flowing from our hand to another hand to get what we desire. Then the third thing I would suggest is that now that you save, and now that you've learned how to use your money and not plastic, I would say give. Charity giving is awesome to the spirit. Now, I do know for some of us who are believers, we do tithes and offering, and that's sort of a little bit easy and a little bit more practical as well as familiar to us because, you know, we've been doing it since we were children. We've learned it in Bible school and Sunday school and everything. However, I'm going to encourage you to either choose charity that you want to give to for the entire year of 2024 or choose a different charity each month that you would like to give to. And I would encourage you to do this in advance so you can get into the habit of looking at, hey, I want to give this year. I want to give to this organization this year. It can be a sentimental organization for you, or it could just be an act of just wanting to give. So those are the three things that I would encourage you to do for this series on coaching regarding your finance. Let's get our monies together. And the way we get our monies together and the way we show that we are getting our money together is by how disciplined we think about money and how we use our money. Thank you so much. I'll see you soon. Bye.